coming up on Sports Zone.
January was a busy month for Duhawks, and you weren't here to see it. What a bummer.
Men's volleyball is in their third season and causing commotion on the court.
And managers, what exactly is their job?
All this and more is starting right now.
Hey, welcome back to Sports Zone.
I'm Dimitri Villanueva alongside Ali Coletta, ready to bring you the latest and greatest in Duhawk athletics.
J-term means there's a lot of Duhawks are off campus and missing major events on the athletic fields.
And while you were at home eating candy canes and staying warm, Duhawks were working hard in the athletic department.
Volleyball's in its third season, wrestling has some standout studs, women's basketball was on a 6-game win streak, and men were on a 12-game win streak. Did you catch all that?
Men's volleyball is in their third season at Loras, and they're making some waves. In their first month of the season, the team went 3-2. Junior Dylan Ross was named champion and offensive player of the week.
He started his freshman year only 3 rotations, and you know now he's a 6 rotation outside hitter, and you know getting conference weekly honors, which speaks to his hard work. He's worked really hard in the gym. He watches film. He comes in extra.
Rolling on over to the mats, wrestling has some D3 rankings. Freshman Guy Patron is sitting at 10th in the rankings in the 197 weight class. Junior Jimmy Davis, weighing in at 157, is 9th in his weight class. With the last chance invite on Saturday, a lot is on the line for these Duhawks. Onto the basketball court, both the men and women's basketball team didn't mess around. The men's team went on quite the run with a 12-game winning streak. Simpson stopped the run, but with the help of Danny Quinn and Matt Dacey-Seho, the team is doing pretty well for themselves. As for the women's, they went on a 6-game win streak before crossing paths with Wartburg. Unfortunately, the Knights brought a little bit more effort to come out with the win to end January.
Wartburg deservedly won. We need to be better so we can beat teams instead of the other way around.
Clearly, J-term was eventful. Struggling for Sports Zone.
Did you catch all that?
I'm Ali Coletta.
One of those mentioned athletes will be stepping into our studio in a little while, so stick around for that. A new position will be filled by one of our very own Duhawks. On February 3rd, it was announced that Denise Udelhoven was named to the NCAA Division III Management Council. Consisting of 21 members, this council reports to the President's Council and oversees any decisions that will be made at the D3 level regarding rules, regulations, and sanctions.
I'm excited. You know, I've been on a bunch of regional committees and on national committees. I really enjoyed being on the Men's National Golf Committee. And what I really enjoy is meeting people from all over the United States.
The school over the hill around the corner is no longer the Clark Crusaders. At the start of the 2017 academic school year, Clark will be known as the Clark Pride. The school believed that the student athletics were not fully represented by the old mascot and wanted to change it to embody a better character. Incoming recruits and students are already being referred to as the future Pride instead of Crusaders. The school is looking forward to embodying the new character in the future. Now just over the other hill at the University of Dubuque, Loras took to the mats in an attempt to hold their win streak. Starting off rough, the Duhawks began trailing the Spartans, but senior Evan Weaver rolled in, taking down Dubuque's Yavante Yarbrough. Continuing the streak, freshman Eddie Smith and junior Owas Arain both wasted no time in winning the matches. In comes freshman Guy Patron, knowing his team needed points to make a comeback, pinning Dubuque's Raven Rodriguez in no time flat, giving this one to Duhawks 24-22.
Coming back from like 22 to 10, it's just exciting. It was great to see the guys come out fired up.
If you want to watch some intense wrestling, head over to the AWC tomorrow night, where the Wartburg Knights will be making a visit at 7 p.m.
The men's volleyball team traveled to Cincinnati, Ohio this weekend to take on the Lions from Mount St. Joseph. The Duhawks, Aaron Miller, rocked the match with 7 kills and 11 digs, right there with him with Greg Kinney. On the other side of the net, Alex Volan took the ball into his own court and had 18 kills and 9 digs. His aggressive offense and defense helped seal the Lions' fate with a win 3-1. The Duhawks travel home for a match against Benedictine on Friday.
Now, the ideal teammate is not always the best athlete on the court.
Reporter John Wardioff takes a look into a different type of athlete.
Duhawk volleyball players Jeffrey Buds and Paul Krause are recognized as team captains for their presence off the court rather than on.
I wanted to help the team in any way I could, any possible facet of the game, and that facet was cheering. So me, Paul, Eric, and like the entire bench mob, we were just like, hey, let's do this. Let's go nuts every game. Let's inspire, it'll help bring some energy to the court. And even though we can't be on the court, let's bring the energy to the court and just try to help the guys win as much as we can.
But what truly makes an ideal teammate?
I think being an ideal teammate is just being there for everyone when they're down, whether the game's up, down, you know. Every game, every sport has its highs and lows, and the ideal teammate is kind of there to just keep them right at that same level, keep it pretty high, but not too crazy high. And even just during practice and stuff, they just work hard. They might not be the best athlete, but they're the one that's there every day working hard as they can.
These two are at every game, cheering on their teammates, just letting them know they have their backs.
Say, hey, we love when you're loud. We hear you guys. They might not acknowledge us when they're on the court, but they know that we're there for them, and it gives them that moral support of just, even if they miss a swing or the serve goes in the bottom of the net, like, they know that we're still there for them and that we still back them up all the time.
Reporting from the bench, I'm John Wertyhoff.
The men's and women's track team took to the road this weekend to Illinois Wesleyan. Both teams came home with a third place finish as a team, but for the women's individuals, Gabrielle Nolan for the 60-meter dash crossed the line in third with a time of 7:97. No surprise here, Audrey Miller ran the 3,000-meter in 9:52 and beat the clock for first place. Moving on over to the men, Killian Lally in the 800-meter finished first with a time of 1:57. Doubling the distance, Brian Nugent finished first in the mile with a time of 4:22. The teams travel up Highway 61 to UW-Platteville on Saturday.
Basketball was on the road as well on Saturday, facing off against Buena Vista. Jump right into it. Aggressive defense by Opendorf led to one of the only Duhok three-pointers in the game, hit by Miranda Chapman right here. They don't need the high scoring, though. They would walk away with a win 58-53. On to the men's game. BV going into this game sitting at 10-2, Loras at 8-4. Needless to say, it was a back-and-forth battle until the end. Jumped to the final minutes of the game after a rebound from Christian Mathis. Duhawks fly down the court and push the ball around the arc, looking for a perfect shot. After taking some time, the ball falls back into Mathis' hands and into the basket. The Duhawks ended the game 71-70.
After eventful away games, the Duhawks are happy to return to home court, which is where we find Kelly tonight.
Well, they both looked pretty excited during warm-ups. Both teams are coming off of big wins on Saturday, which has to be to blame for that. Both teams are facing off against Central. For the women, Central is last in their division. Our Duhawks are sitting at 7-5, which puts us at third. The player to watch on the court tonight is Lauren Stonick. In their last game, Stonick broke the record for points scored in a game at 30. So hopefully she continues that groove tonight. As for the men, the Dutch are sitting right behind Loras in the ranks for fourth. Christian Mathis and Justin Van Wombeck are the players to watch on the court. Both of them scored 13 points in the last game. The women's game is going on right now, and the Duhawks just scored. That's all I have for you guys. Back to you in the studio.
The Dubuque Fighting Saints face Cedar Rapids Saturday night. After coming off two road wins that landed Dubuque in first place, Taylor Brearley of Dubuque put the Saints up 1-0 in the first. In the second period, Cedar Rapids scored twice to put the Rough Riders ahead 2-1 at the end of the second. In the third period, Zach Solo tied the game midway through the third, and Cedar Rapids responded late in the period to take a 3-2 lead. Dubuque was able to tie the game and force overtime. It was Cedar Rapids with the game-winning goal with 0.9 seconds left to give Cedar Rapids the victory 4-3 in Dubuque. We caught up with head coach Jason Lammers on how Dubuque continued to fight and stay in the game.
Yeah, just a lot of courage. We thought they showed a lot of will to come back, keep coming back, and obviously three games and three nights and the travel and all that, that was challenging, but we're real impressed with how courageous they were.
Dubuque's next game will be Friday night in Madison as they will enter the weekend in sole possession of first place.
All right, now it's time for everyone's favorite part of the show, Buffalo Wild Wings trivia.
All right, here we go. Well, actually, because it's the first show, we'll recap the rules. We're going to ask the question. You tweet in your answer to LCTV_sports or email us at lctv@loras.edu. The first person to get the correct answer in will receive a free snack size of wings.
All right. Are you ready?
Now I'm ready.
Here's the question. How many games did the men's basketball team win before they played Simpson? Is it A, 6, B, 11, or C, 13?
Get those guesses in and we'll get back to you later in the show.
Now, don't you dare touch that remote. Coming up after the break, we talk to some students who play a major role on the sidelines.
And we bring in a volleyball player who has caused some commotion on the court.
My father taught me a lot about life, without ever saying a word. When I was a little girl, my friends were all just like me. His never were.
Hello, hello.
Didn't you bring them, George?
I thought you were
going. No, I brought them last time.
Huh? You're all right. I forgot. All right, so all right. We'll be with
you. I used to wonder, why would a Jew, a Christian, and a Muslim ever get together?
It was him!
And then I finally got it. They had a lot more in common than donuts.
Friendship. Pass it on. A message from the Foundation for a Better Life.
Thanks for sticking around. Joining us now is junior Dylan Ross, who is part of the men's volleyball team. Dylan, thanks so much for coming in. So we heard a little bit from your coach earlier about your high school career and stuff like that. And he said you didn't play club. What did you do in high school?
In high school, I was a three-sport athlete. I played golf and then basketball and then volleyball.
So why did you choose Loras to play volleyball?
I had a few scholarships for golf, but I never really wanted to play golf in college and really just wanted to play volleyball. And I had a few friends that were coming here already from the school, so I figured, why not?
Fair enough. So can you talk a little bit about the transformation that the team and you have had since when you stepped out on the court that first practice to now it's your third season?
Definitely a huge change where, you know, first year with the program, it was just a lot of people that have never played before, and now it's just like transforming into all Jeremy's recruits and everything, and really like forming into a real team.
Cool. Now, do you have like a favorite school you like to travel to or play at?
I always love playing at home. Home games are the best, but away games, I would have to say like Benedictine, Dominican, and North Central, just because they're in Chicago, they're home for me. So
I like Benedictine too. It's a nice school. So off the court, what are some of the hobbies that you like to do?
Just hanging out with the friends. We play a lot of rock band at our house with Shane, Leo, and Jeff. We always love to stay up probably later than we should and rock out.
Cool.
It happens.
So you used to have a mullet. What happened to that?
You know, it was cut off in New York in a hotel room actually by my roommate Shane.
Oh, no.
Captains Jeff and Paul, they said that hair can't be touching the collar anymore, so wow. It had to go.
Were you sad?
Yeah, it was weird the next day, just not having hair on my neck anymore.
Wow, yeah. Well, thank you so much for joining us and coming into the studio. Good luck with the rest of your season. Hopefully we'll get out to some of those games.
Thank you.
Now, some athletes come to school knowing they want to play a sport, and other athletes come to school with a different job in mind.
Reporter Seth Kilberg looks into a different job on the court.
Athletes sit in the limelight as soon as they put their feet on the court. But what about students who aren't athletes? They're the managers. Meet Pat and Lauren, the managers for the Duhok basketball teams. How exactly did they get into working the bench?
I just really thought that this would be a good opportunity for me to, you know, kickstart my career and propel me into what I want to do after school. I've always wanted to be involved in a sports organization, be involved in the media side of things, or maybe even get into coaching.
So because I'm from Dubuque, I've come to Loras games like my whole entire life. So throughout high school, obviously I played in high school and I've always loved the game. So, and I knew the assistant coach at the time that was coaching up here.
As managers, they take on a variety of responsibilities.
I do the scoreboard during all the practices. I just help out when the coaches need me to.
A lot of stuff is like just taking care of the team in general. So as far as making sure all the food's ordered and it's on time and it's the right stuff, which we have trouble doing sometimes since there's 25 people. A lot of times on away trips, so we don't have to stop, and it helps to get all that done ahead of time.
But the best part?
I would be just still being around the guys. You know, I get to travel with the team, get to see how Coach Martin gets to run a program.
Being able to be a part of it without like playing, but still feeling like I'm totally needed and I'm totally like a part of it regardless of whether I put a jersey on or I'm wearing heels down the court.
Reporting for Sports Zone, Seth Kilberg.
We've got one more break coming at you. And behind that, Allie and I challenge our inner quarterback skills.
And one of our reporters dives into a new segment, one of celebrations.
What do you guys want to do?
I don't know. What do you want to do?
I don't know. What do you want to do?
1, 2, ready, go. Gonna pull the stops, gonna make it go. You're living on a wheel.
Glad you're still with us for this next segment. Allie and I hit the field to channel some celebrities that were in the limelight this past week.
Check out this week's Sports Challenge.
We're here at the Rock Bowl to recreate the Super Bowl that just happened this Sunday. I'm going to be the Patriots and Allie's going to be the Falcons.
You've got three chances each to throw at the Doritos and the Pepsi. Whoever gets closest wins.
Hit me.
Ready. Looks like I was aiming more at Dimitri's face and not the Doritos bag. Oops. That was close. I hope you miss. Well, neither one of us are really cut out to be quarterbacks.
But I think I am cut out to eat some of these Doritos.
You're ridiculous.
You awesome.
You know, I'm really upset I didn't hit more of the items because I was a quarterback in middle school.
Wow. You know, maybe the middle school Dimitri and the college Dimitri just, you know, you lost some skill.
Yeah, I guess so.
Oh, you know, it's okay. You still won, so that's something, right?
Yeah.
All right. Well, while Dimitri celebrates by eating some Doritos, some athletes on campus have special ways that they celebrate their success. Check it out.
This is the first segment of celebrations here on Sports Zone, and we're here with Mark, and he brought two people with him.
Liam.
Alex.
Because he couldn't do this alone. But hey, it's all good. Sometimes you need more than one person to celebrate. We're going to show you how he did this season against Co.
The Dewhawks, and it is 5-0 as we see right here. An absolutely great celebration.
So, Mark, that day when you went up to the camera, why'd you start punching the camera? Where'd you get that from?
It's from FIFA, and I always had that celebration planned, and I knew I was going to do it on my first goal. So they always tell us to celly hard, and that's what I did.
Do you have any advice for the young soccer players out there that want to celly hard just like you did?
Play some FIFA, you know, watch some pros, they celly hard, and you can get some from them.
You heard it here first, folks. Play FIFA, you'll celly hard.
You know, that celebration definitely deserves some Buffalo Wild Wings, and so do one of you. So let's recap that question. How many games did the men's basketball team win before they played Simpson? Is it A, 6, B, 11, or C, 13?
And the answer is B, 11. Congratulations to Pat Hunt. You were the first answer to get it.
Tune in next week for your chance to win some more free food.
Well, that's all we have for you tonight.
We're going to head on down to the AWC to catch the men's game, and you should too.
Stay up to date on all other athletics through the week and follow us at LCTV_sports.
LCTV News is back next week, same time, same place.
As for us, we'll be back in 2 weeks with more of the latest and greatest in Dewhawk athletics.
We'll see you later.